take a look around your local library or Starbucks. You'll notice that most students are plugging away at their studying with headphones on. But is it actually beneficial to listen to music while you study? In this video, we'll dive into the research and help you determine if studying with music is a good idea for you. What's going on, guys? Dr. Jabal, MedSchoolInsiders.com. First, let's dispel some of the common myths you may have heard regarding music and studying, starting with the Mozart effect. The Mozart effect describes a brief 10 to 15 minute enhancement of spatial-temporal abilities in college students after listening to a Mozart piano sonata. More specifically, this improvement is restricted to a singular abstract mental rotation task. But in the 90s, this took hold as a scientific legend, with lay people convinced that listening to Mozart was going to make their kids more intelligent. And I remember that when I was in elementary school, several of my teachers would have us work for extended periods of time while listening to classical music for precisely this reason. This finding was initially found by Roscher and colleagues in 1993, but attempts to replicate these findings by other researchers have yielded mixed results. Peichnig and colleagues in 2010 performed a meta-analysis, meaning they systematically analyzed dozens of studies on the Mozart effect to determine what the culmination of the scientific literature had to say on the subject. Interestingly, they found that studies associated with certain labs, like the lab of Roscher, were much more likely to report favorable results. Additionally, they demonstrated a confounding publication bias, therefore requiring a downward correction of the reported effects. So their conclusion? On the whole, there is little evidence left for a specific performance-enhancing Mozart effect. It's safe to say that the Mozart effect does not improve intelligence in children, it does not improve academic achievement, and it does not even improve long-term spatial skills. To determine if and when you should listen to music while you study, we first need to explore the relevant hypotheses. There are a few hypotheses that hinge on arousal states and its effect on performance. First, the arousal hypothesis states that music leads to an optimal level of arousal in the brain, thus improving performance on cognitive tasks. The mood hypothesis states that music you enjoy is more likely to put you in a positive mood, which ultimately improves arousal states and therefore enhances performance on spatial tasks. Lastly, the preference hypothesis states that listening to music you prefer improves arousal, thus enhancing cognitive performance. Others have suggested a rhythm theory, whereby the rhythm of music activates the cerebellum and aids in spatial reasoning tasks. However, none of these hypotheses are robust. Each has significant deficiencies in explaining these scientific findings. So rather, we must take a much more individualized approach to music and to studying, as it appears that three factors are key in determining whether music is beneficial while studying: personality type, the type of work, and the type of music. Christopher and colleagues in 2017 hypothesized that differences in attention and working memory capacity would affect the degree to which music would influence performance. They concluded that the higher an individual's working memory capacity, the less likely they were to be affected by music, at least for reading comprehension. Dobbs and colleagues in 2011 found that music had a detrimental effect in performance on introverts, but less so for extroverts. This aligns with Eysenck's theory of cortical arousal states, stating that extroverts are understimulated and desire more stimulation, whereas introverts are already overstimulated, and therefore they avoid situations that further increase their arousal. Anderson and Fuller in 2010 found an interesting tie with metacognition and music. Metacognition is essentially thinking about thinking, and it includes the ability to regulate one's own mental processes and activity. So given the substantial evidence that music while studying is not optimal, they believe that those who choose to may ultimately just have a deficiency in metacognition. They had students choose whether they wanted to study with music or in silence, and they found that those who preferred to listen to music while they studied did markedly worse on a reading comprehension assessment. Now, there has been substantial evidence that the type of work is a key factor in determining whether or not music is appropriate. When it comes to reading comprehension, most studies have demonstrated that music has detrimental effects. Only one study reported that reading comprehension was unaffected by music. But when it comes to arithmetic, the results are quite mixed. A handful of studies demonstrate no negative effect, while a handful of others demonstrate a clear decline. Now, a few studies have demonstrated that vocal music is more distracting than instrumental music. The theory is that with vocals, your brain is multitasking by processing the voices while you are trying to study. Beyond that, there hasn't been any convincing evidence stating that a certain genre, like classical music, is superior to any other type of music. And now, the moment that you've all been waiting for. Should you study with music or in silence? As with most things in science, it depends. My advice is as follows. First, if you are going to study with music, be sure to choose music that lacks vocals. Vocals are going to be distracting and ultimately much more likely to have a detrimental effect on your studying. Beyond that, choose music you enjoy. Contrary to popular belief, there is no evidence that classical music is superior for studying. Finding instrumental music you enjoy is going to be the most important factor. I personally opt for Emancipator, Edamame, Black Mill, and several others. I send out study music recommendations in my weekly newsletter. If you're interested, sign up on the Med School Insider's website. Link is in the description below. Second, experiment with different study scenarios. Unfortunately, the scientific literature is far from conclusive, so self-experimentation becomes very important. So back in college, and this is prior to me reading any research about music and studying, I had quickly determined from my own experience that listening to music while reading was on average more distracting than reading in silence. But when it came to cranking through chemistry or physics practice problems, music made the experience more enjoyable. You will likely find similar results, but try it out for yourself. You'll notice that some types of work are more conducive to music than others. I also learned that having a good study song on repeat helped me get in the zone and study for longer periods of time without fatigue. This is supported by the changing state hypothesis, which suggests that rapidly changing music will distract you from learning and ultimately decrease your performance. I would often have HR 8938 by Deadmau5 on repeat. From examining the literature, it is clear that music won't make you magically perform better or learn faster. The question is finding which type of music is going to be the least distracting and the least detrimental. Study after study has examined the effect of silence versus music while doing a variety of cognitive tasks. The issue, however, is that no study has examined the effects of music on prolonged study sessions. From personal experience, I believe that music has helped me study for longer periods of time. I often start working in silence, and as I feel myself getting bored or my mind wandering, I'll put on some instrumental music that I enjoy. With this newfound burst in energy and positive vibes, I'm able to marathon with my studying for much longer. My suggestion to you is to try the same. Use music as a boost or a pick-me-up when your momentum begins to drop. Now, I went through dozens of primary literature articles and condensed my findings in this short video. If you want to learn more about the process of how I researched, wrote, and created this video, I have behind-the-scenes access on Patreon. Your support goes a long way in helping me make these videos. As a patron, you'll get commentary for each upload, where I go over additional insights that I couldn't fit in the YouTube video. I also have a monthly Q&A exclusively for Patreon supporters, as well as live monthly video chats with yours truly. Thank you all so much for watching. Do you like studying with music or in silence? Let me know your favorite artists and songs below, because I am always looking for new music recommendations. If you liked the video, let me know with a thumbs up. And if you were not a fan, I don't mind if you leave a thumbs down. Hit subscribe and the notification bell so you don't miss any new uploads. And I will see you guys in that next one.